Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to Stardew Valley. In the last episode, we successfully managed to find all 9 items that we're going to be taking with us to the Stardew Valley Fair, and we also found that Robin started working on our new kitchen upgrade. She's actually still over here because she said it's going to take, I believe, 3 days for her to finish our new kitchen. So yesterday was day 1, today is day 2, and tomorrow is going to be day 3, which ironically is the very same day as the Stardew Valley Fair, so that's a little bit unfortunate in terms of timing. But I think it'll be okay. It just means that tomorrow is going to be a jam-packed day full of things for us to discover. And today, I would actually like to do some fishing because with our kitchen upgrade done, I noticed that we have a lot of recipes that involve fish of some sort. So today is going to be a fishing day, but first let's check this letter to see if there's anything important in here. Dear Jess, I just want to remind you that the Stardew Valley Fair is happening tomorrow. Don't forget to bring your 9 items for the grand display. Remember, the fair starts at 9 a.m. in the town square. See you there. From Mayor Lewis. Thank you, Mayor Lewis. Now we will certainly remember that tomorrow is the fair. And oh my gosh, is our corn ready today? Is this our corn? I think it is. Yes, that's our corn. So that means that the bundle for the fall crops will be done. Oh my goodness. So we did have corn. We actually had corn, guys. I was a little bit worried, even though I was pretty sure that we had managed to get all of the fall crops that we needed for the Junimos, I was still just a little bit worried that we may have missed out on one. And it looks like we just have a couple more crops to water here. I have a feeling that I might need to take another trip down to Pierre's to get some more seeds because I don't like how sparse this is right now. It definitely seems like we need just a few more seeds to keep the place full and thriving, so we'll definitely have a lot more gold coming in for the rest of the season. But I think I may need to fill up my watering can too. I love the copper watering can because it's so much easier to water all of our crops now, especially now that I know how to properly use it. I'm getting better at that. I'm still occasionally watering places that I don't want to water, but I think I'm getting a little bit better at it, so it's taking a little bit less time to water all of these crops that we have on Cattail Farm. And of course, I'm going to go say hi to Daisy too. I see you're sitting up there by our beautiful little scarecrow. Making friends with our scarecrow, of course. Yesterday it said that Daisy loves us, and I am so happy about that. That made me so happy. That was so sweet. I do want to take a quick peek in here too to see if our fruit bats left us anything. They left us one little wild plum. Yesterday it was one little salmon berry, and today it's one little wild plum. So that's kind of adorable. Thank you, fruit bats. And all these leaves. I love it when the leaves blow in the wind. It's so nice. And our chickens are definitely enjoying their time here too because now they have 1.5 hearts. So I have a feeling that pretty soon we'll be getting some pretty good quality eggs coming in because they're having a pretty nice time on our farm. I'm just going to move all this out of the way so we can properly pick up our hay here and make sure that they always have a nice little meal to munch on just in case we happen to forget about them again, which I hope will not happen, but I mean, it's always a possibility because there's so much to do in Stardew Valley. First though, since I want to make today a fishing day, we need to go into my chest here and grab our bug meat because we need to make more bait. We actually went fresh out of bait as of yesterday, so we definitely need to come down here and make a whole bunch more. I'm going to make a lot because you can make 5 out of just 1 piece of bug meat. So let's make 100. Let's go all out and make 100 pieces of bait because I'm not sure if there's really anything else that we need to use the bug meat for, but I haven't found another use yet. So it seems like that's probably a good way to use it up. And now let's see if I can properly do this here. I'm gonna take about half of our bait here and try to attach it. There we go. Okay, so you just right click on whatever you're attaching your bait to and it puts it right on our fiberglass rod here. That's our rod of choice for the day. So it's a little bit easier than I thought it was going to be. I had a lot of trouble with that before, actually. But now that I know how to do that, it also makes it quite a bit easier. So now we also have some leftover bait to bring to our crab pots too, which I also would like to do because we do want to keep up on our crab pots, even though we've already completed the crab pot bundle. I feel like it's probably a good thing to just make sure that we're properly refilling our crab pots full of bait, and maybe we'll get something special. You never know. But first, before we do any of that, I need to make sure that I go to the Junimos and give them their new ear of corn, which should successfully finish the entire bundle. And I believe the pantry is actually getting pretty close to being completely done. We probably only need a couple more. So our fall crops, here is your lovely piece of corn. There we go. A little bit of trouble placing it there, but bundle is complete. What do we get for that? Oh my gosh, a bee house. Place outside and wait for delicious honey, except in winter. Oh, but the winter is coming up soon, guys. Oh my gosh. Well, at least he's carrying his adorable little bundle away. He's putting it in his little hut here, which is very, very cute. And now we have a bee house. That is so cool. Oh my gosh. So we're at least going to have a few more weeks left of the fall time before the bees decide to go away for the season. So we'll definitely have to go place that there. Actually, why don't we go do that right now? That might be a good thing. And we'll place the rest of our corn. And I believe we had some pumpkins to put into the little bin to sell off as well. And I also want to take a quick peek down toward the south of our mine, not our mine, the south of our farm where Marnie lives. Because in the last episode, we unfortunately found that strange traveling caravan again when it was too late. There was nobody there. It wasn't open, I guess. So we need to go see if it's still there. I'm guessing it probably isn't. That just seems to be how this always goes. I'm going to place this right down here next to our furnaces, because why not? This seems like it's probably a pretty good place. It's kind of similar, right? Hopefully they will appreciate that. Hopefully we'll get a lot of little tiny bees buzzing around in there very, very soon. I will, of course, keep the eggs on us because I always like to have the eggs for gifts just in case we run into anyone. And I'm going to bring that Joja Cola again in case we see Sam because we just missed him last time. And we have some mixed seeds. Okay, I forgot about those. We can actually pop those right into the ground here. Just while we're here, we'll pop those right down. There we go. And then we just need to water them too. So the mixed seeds will grow into different random things that can be found in the fall time, which is always fun to do because you never know what you're gonna get, I guess. So let's just take a quick peek down here, and then I guess we could do some fishing down in that area as well, by the area where Marnie lives. I guess that's lake fishing again. I think that would be considered another lake. Now, I'm guessing there's gonna be nothing here. I'm just assuming. Let's see. Is there anything here? Well, there's Jazz. She's jumping rope. And of course, that caravan is gone. Of course. Did you see it last night, Jazz? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh no, I messed up again. Sorry, Jazz. I know we messed you up. We messed you up by distracting you. But let's see what's in this little lake here. Hopefully something good. Hopefully it's not full of trash like the pond on our farm, because that's all we ever seem to get from that pond. I have never caught a fish there. Oh no, that's not a good sign. I have never ever caught an actual fish on our own farmland. And I'm not sure. Oh, I missed that one. I'm not sure if that's because we need to clean up the area more before there's good fish there. I'm really not sure. Or if that's just how it is. Maybe we're just destined to never be able to catch fish. And this is not a good sign. So I'm just going to leave it because we don't want to use up all of our bait on trash. That would be really, really silly considering we just made all of that bait, over 100 pieces. We don't want to waste it on soggy newspaper and driftwood. You would think that fish would be more likely to grab our bait than soggy newspaper, but I guess that's just the way things are. Let's take a quick peek in here to see if Sam is home, though. I don't think he is. Sam, no, you're not home. Actually, nobody is home right now. Vincent's not in, and neither is Jody, who is their mother. So nobody's home. I guess they're all out and about enjoying the lovely fall day. Oh, there's Jody. She's going home. Maybe she was just going shopping or something. Who knows? There's Caroline and there's Alex. We'll give Alex another egg because he really seems to enjoy those. So here you go, Alex. This is cool. Thanks. He does seem to enjoy those very, very much. And then I think we're going to go down to the beach here. Oh, there's Harvey. Hello, Harvey. We need to find better gifts for you, too. He seems to like the forage items, which kind of makes sense because they all tend to give different bits of energy to you. And I see worms and I need to smack them. It's only clay, but I think we can use the clay to make more buildings later on. So I am stockpiling as much clay as I can possibly find. Oh my gosh, look at this haul of trash over here. Wow. Wow, guys. Though we did get a lobster and some shells as well, so I guess it's not too bad. And we will fill those up again with all of this lovely bait that we crafted earlier. Hopefully I won't pick any of these up by accident. I think I'm doing good today. I think I'm actually doing pretty good, so not bad at all. And we'll pick up the shells over here too, because these tend to sell for quite a bit of gold, so I like to have those on hand. But after we clean up this area, I am going to attempt to fish. I feel like we may have fished on this little pier before, but I'm not sure what we got. I'm not sure if we got any fish or if it was all trash down here. So we're going to experiment and see what we get. Oh, it's a fish. It's actually a fish. Okay, don't you go away from me, little fish. We're gonna get you. We're gonna get you this time. What is it gonna be? Let's see. Oh, it's a little sardine. It's actually a big sardine because it's a new record. Oh gosh, guys. Oh gosh. Okay, let's throw away our trash. There's that. There's the driftwood. I don't think we need any of that. And we'll keep our lovely sardine on us. And let's fish again. Let's see what else we can get here. I'm a little bit worried that we don't have enough space now for all of the fish that I wanted to catch. And it's actually getting really late too. Oh gosh, and we just got seaweed. Okay, well there's another thing that we can throw away if we get a pretty good fish. Oh, okay, that was another fish there. This is going pretty fast actually. Oh no, not this again. Not this again. Okay, go up a little bit, little fish. Go up, go up, go up. Oh no. Oh, I missed the fish. Oh no, and I missed them both. I thought I would at least get the chest. Oh no, chest. You missed them both that time. That could have been a really good fish too. It was really feisty. So I wonder what it was. Typically the feisty fish are the ones that are pretty good. Okay, this one's kind of feisty again. Not this again. No. Twice in a row. Come on, little fish. Go down a little bit. Usually the fish tend to stay at the bottom for me for some reason. But not this one. Okay, I think I might actually salvage this. And actually, that may have not been a good idea anyway, because we have, like, no room in our pockets. So if we have something really good, I'm gonna be upset. An albacore? That's actually a new fish. Okay, and what did we get in the treasure chest? Another one? No, okay, that's just what we caught. That confused me for a moment. Okay, so let's get rid of the seaweed. And our geode. We kind of need the geodes because those are cool. I like to crack those open. We'll just, we'll replace the clam, actually, because the clams are pretty plentiful in the beach area, so we probably don't need to worry about not being able to find clams for a while now, but I guess that's all the fishing we can really do right now, unless we empty our pockets really, really fast. I should have made one of those warp totems. I totally forgot about that. Maybe we should think about doing that sometime soon in one of the next episodes. Tomorrow's definitely going to be jam-packed. We have so many things to do tomorrow. So I don't know if we're going to get it done then. But let's see. Is there anyone in the saloon that would like an egg? Let's see. It's actually a pretty quiet night. So I think we're probably going to give our egg to Shane because we know he likes eggs. Oh my gosh, we got a new achievement. Oh my gosh. This is great. Thanks. Clicks. Okay. So I guess we're doing really well here. Oh my gosh, look at how many friends we have. We have four different people with 5 hearts. So that must be something to do with that achievement down there. Abigail is way up at the top now. I wasn't expecting that actually. We gave her a really nice gift for her birthday though. She loved the amethyst that we gave her on her birthday. So I guess it has something to do with her being way at the top. And then of course Sam is here and Emily and Shane. Shane, who is back in our good graces after we accidentally gave him that snail. And he was really offended by it. And I was offended too because he called it trash. And I thought it was adorable, but oh well. Oh well, we learned from our mistakes here. And let's see, who's at the bottom again? I always like to see who's at the bottom. And it's always the same people here. Clint actually has 1 heart though. That's actually surprising. So we're getting on Clint's good side. But Sebastian, poor Sebastian, is down here with no hearts. And Vincent and Pierre. So we really need to work on them. We really need to figure out what they actually like. And we need to get those as gifts and give them to those poor, poor people who hate us. But let's see, tomorrow is the fair. And then we have Murnie's birthday, Robin's birthday, and George's birthday coming up. So we need to remember all of those, and we need to make sure that we have the proper gifts to give them all. Murnie's probably going to be very easy because we already know that she really likes the eggs, the fresh eggs that we get every morning from our lovely chickens. So I don't think that'll be a problem. Though that reminds me, with winter around the corner, our chickens are actually going to need heaters, I think, in their little house, in their little chicken homes over there, their chicken coops. So we're going to have to make sure that we have enough gold left over in the wintertime to give them a little heater so they don't freeze. Because we certainly don't want to see that happen. That would be awful. I'm going to keep our geode on hand so I don't forget about it. And I'm also going to put our fish in this chest over here. So again, I don't forget about it because I will probably just throw that right in the bin if I have that in my inventory. I typically sell all the fish that we catch. And I guess I shouldn't have done that because we have a lot of different fish recipes to make for when Robin finally finishes our little kitchen. Oh, she looks so tired. Look at her. I feel really bad for her. She spends a lot of time working. She works literally all through the night. Poor Robin. Your house should be ready tomorrow. Oh, yay. I'm really excited about that, though. Thank you, Robin. Thank you for all of your kind work. We really need to give her more gifts, too, because we don't typically give her a lot of gifts, and she spends so much time working on our little farm that I feel like we really need to properly reward her for doing so. Let's light up this area a little bit. I really want to go through and light up all of the paths in Stardew Valley, because I believe even though this isn't technically our farmland here, we can go over here and still place down torches along the way, and that way it'll just be so much easier for us to see when we're going through the town late at night like this. So I don't have enough torches on hand right now, but in the future, especially as winter rolls around, we are going to light this up as best as we can, so we'll always be able to see where we're going, because usually when I take big trips into the mines, I end up stumbling home very, very late at night, and then I can't see where I'm going because there's no torches. This torch actually used to light up when I balanced it on my head, and I love that so much, but unfortunately, it seems like that went away. I'm not sure if it's a glitch, or maybe it was a glitch before, and now it's just been properly patched. But I miss that. I miss the days when I could have a lit torch balanced on my head. Probably not the safest thing in retrospect. Probably not very safe at all to balance lit torches right above your hair. But it was nice while it lasted, guys. It certainly was. So it's getting very, very late now. I guess we will tuck Jess into bed. And Daisy's over here by the fire, of course, enjoying her little nap as well. And our lovely bear, you are going to have plenty of room to spread your big chubby legs pretty soon, Mr. Bear. Oh my goodness. Hopefully pretty soon we'll be able to make more rooms in our house too. It would be nice to have like a separate little bedroom that we can just place our bed and some of our more ridiculous things, like this big bear and our lovely paintings. Because right now it's very cramped in here. We have a lot of stuff and not many places to put it. So it'll be really nice once our house is properly expanded and we are getting ever so closer to being able to do so. But for now, we're going to tuck Jess into bed and get ready for tomorrow, when our kitchen will be ready and it will also be the Stardew Valley Fair. So thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye!